Welcome back. We're going to check out creating users. And once we've created them, hey, what to do if some of their details change? Users can be basically anywhere, and the nature of Gsuite via its web browser interface makes it accessible to all your users. But how do you create them in the first place? Let's find out. Okay, so here we are back in the Google Admin Console. What we're going to do now is we're going to take a look at our users and click on the users icon. Now, as it's all web-based, it's all pretty straightforward. But what we're going to do is we're going to take a quick look how to create a user. So, we've got three users, including myself, Kernel Collaboration, right here. We're going to add a new user. That comes to a pop-up window. We'll type in the name of our user. Sarah. We could have collaboration. Let's call it something else. Sarah, I don't know. Sarah Jeffrey. Don't know why that is. The email address. You then have the opportunity of, do you swap the first name, depending how big your organization is, or do you want to have some differentiation, so, and also have the surname? So we'll have the surname in there. Organizational unit is the collaboration kernel, and we'll come on to organizational units in a further lesson. A secondary email, well, you can put a secondary email address in your if you want, so we can say sarahjeffrey@gmail.com, for example. We'll say 8877 4455. Just in case. Phone number. There's our phone number. And now we get the option to automatically generate a password. Right. Or you can set a password. For example, that good old favorite, password. And you can view it by clicking on the little eye. And then you can prompt that user to change the password next time they sign in. Now, what are the benefits here? If you do it this way, by creating a password, you can test the account depending on how big your environment is. Everyone's got the same account, and you can ask for a password change at the next sign in. So as soon as that person signs in with that password, they can change to whatever they want, and therefore their account is secure. Good then for doing your management of change when you consider this. So you are creating your user account, say to your people, log in, your password's password, your help desk know what the password is, your people know what the password is, and so do you. That's the initial password. Great. The downside of it is nothing stopping other people logging into this account before, say, Sarah has, for example. So, swings and roundabouts. Personally, I quite like the choosing your own password, this process here. If you generate your own password, add new user, Google will go away, generate a password for you, which you can view, copy and paste, email the logon info or print the logon info and send it to the users. Now, it's all good stuff, yeah, I get it. Personally, I'd rather have that little bit of control and set the password myself. Okay, you can also edit the user and add them to a group. Come on to that later. Done. So, there's our user. Now, when we highlight that user, or move the mouse directly over it, you can see you get some quick tasks you can do. Reset the password, rename the user, add to groups, and click on more. Suspend the user. Now, suspending a user, you may want to suspend a user, for example, if they go on maternity leave, or if it's a gentleman, paternity leave. They may be going on sabbatical. Suspend that user. You can also delete the user as well and change the organizational unit which is in, and we'll cover organizational units in a further lesson. Or you can email the user nice and quick from the admin console. So, there you have it. What we're going to do, we're going to rename the user. Sarah has got married. Her name is now Dennis, right? And it says, renaming a user is a system-wide change that can take up to 10 minutes. Sarah doesn't need to take action and won't see any account profile or Google Plus profile changes. And here's the impacts of renaming a user. Okay, impact of a changing username. So when changing user account details, consider this. And Gsuite has done a good job of putting all the information that you should consider when changing someone's name. Look at this. Gmail. When you change a user's primary address, Gsuite retains the old address as an email alias for the user. Now this means that you could send it to Sarah Jeffrey, no problem. She changes her name because she gets married. It then changes to Sarah Dennis, but people don't know she's got married. Still sends her email to Sarah Jeffrey. She still gets her mail. Couldn't be simpler. It can take up to 24 hours for email alias changes, such as removal of an old alias or addition of a new alias, to be reflected throughout the system. So it's not going to be instantaneous. Things to consider with mobile devices, Gsuite Sync for Microsoft Outlook. If you change a user's username, the user must create a new profile. No problem there. Calendaring. Events created before the user or group rename show the old address. Okay. Or secondary calendars will continue to display the original primary domain name. So there are ramifications for doing it, which have to be considered. So we'll leave the primary email as it is and click rename. It's easier. And there you go, that's how to quickly add a user in Gsuite via the Google Admin Console. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Check back for more videos in the series. Next video up, we're going to be looking at bulk uploading users. See you soon.